गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रेन, टुडे आई विल गिव यू द एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ फोर्थ चैप्टर ऑफ इंग्लिश टू, दैट इज अ वंडरफुल गिफ्ट. दिस स्टोरी इज रिटन बाय अ फेमस अमेरिकन टीचर एंड राइटर हुज नेम इज जेम्स बाल्डविन. सो चिल्ड्रेन, इन दिस स्टोरी इट टेल्स अस हाउ इन ओल्डर डेज पीपल थॉट दैट डूइंग समथिंग क्रिएटिव लाइक painting, singing, acting and so on was not correct. People were even punished for doing things like that, which was very creative. And the events in the story unfolds that the characters of Benjamin West, yes, the main character of this story is a little boy whose name is Benjamin West, who's portrayed as an artist. So the story tells how this little boy whose name was Benjamin West, how he was so much interested in drawing, and how his parents were they were not very much liking this interest in him, that he should not they don't want to encourage him in doing this thing because they thought it is not the correct thing. So this little boy Benjamin West, he was a good boy. He never troubled anyone, not even his parents. And one day when his mother asked, she was going somewhere, and she asked him to look after his baby sister, and that time he got an opportunity to actually try his talent. And when his mother went out for maybe market or somewhere, then for some time he was sitting still, but then he got bored and he was just staring at the beautiful face and little hands of his sister. And then suddenly he realized that what a pretty picture he can draw of his lovely baby sister. Then he did not get anything, the paper or crayons, pencils, nothing he had, because his parents were not keeping it. So what he took a piece of cardboard and charcoal is a small burnt piece of wood which becomes black in color. So he took a piece of cardboard and a piece of charcoal and he started drawing the picture of his baby sister, and it came out to be a very beautiful picture of his. And he was so lost in drawing that he never realized that his mother had come into the room. And when she saw the picture, she was very happy. She was kind of a supporting character in this story. She became very happy, and she was so overjoyed that she hugged her son and kissed her. And later, when she told her husband, like Benjamin's father, about this, he did not openly expressed his view about the picture because he did not want to encourage Benjamin in this drawing thing. But later on they were realizing that this is the talent which their son have, so they took the matter to priest. So the priest, he realized he played an important role in Benjamin's character, in building up Benjamin's character. He played an important role, and he told his parents that your son have got a special wonderful gift and you should not discourage him. Then the boy was finally free to follow his passion, breaking the traditional thinking. And the priest also told the parents that one day their child would make the country proud. So children, this was the story all about, and now we will read the lines and we will see line wise description. So children, open your book, page number 25, A Wonderful Gift. A long time ago there lived in America a little boy named Benjamin West. So this story is from America, and the name of the boy was Benjamin West, about whom this story is all about. Benjamin loved pictures, but he had never seen any pictures except a few small ones in a book. He loved their bright and beautiful colors. His father and mother did not think it was right to spend money for such things. They thought the pictures might take his mind away from more useful things. So Benjamin used to draw. He used to love pictures. He used to love the bright colors in the pictures. He used to admire those bright colors and all, but he had never seen any pictures except means other than. It means he did not see a lot of pictures, only few pictures he seen what was there, which was a few small ones in a book, which was given in his book. Only those pictures he used to see, and that also he used to like a lot. He loved the bright and what was the main thing he used to like about the picture? The bright colors, the beautiful colors. His father and mother did not think it was right to spend money for such things. And as I told you that in old times, in the past, people were not liking all these creativity. So same way, his parents also did not want to encourage Benjamin about all these things, and so they did not buy, and they did not spend money on the crayons, colors, pencils, and gave him to draw. They thought the pictures might take his mind away from means it can divert his mind or make him forget about more useful things. Means he should not concentrate in drawing, but he should concentrate in other useful things. They think that this drawing is such a waste of time, it's a useless thing. One day Benjamin's mother had to go out for some work. She told Benjamin to stay in the house and take care of his baby sister until she came back. So one day when his mother means she has to go out to some work, she asked Benjamin that you are at home, so you have to look after your baby sister. So he was so glad to do this because he loved the baby. She was asleep in her crib for a while. He was very still. He did not want to make any noise and wake her. He could hear the clock ticking. He heard the birds singing. Soon he began to feel a little lonely. So when he heard that he has to look after his baby sister, he was very happy. He was very glad that he is now the bigger one. He's like feeling the responsibility. So for some times he was very happy, and he was not making any movements because he thought that if he'll make any movement, then his sister might wake up. His sister might get up from the sleep, and he did not want to disturb his sister in her sleep. So he was very still means he was not moving, he was sitting very quiet and still so that he could not make any noise. And he could hear the clock tick. It was so silent that he could even hear the sound of the clock tick tick tick, that is ticking. He could hear that. He heard the birds singing, and somewhere outside the house the birds were singing, and because it was so silent, so he could hear the birds singing outside. And after some time he began to feel lonely because he was all alone in the house except for a baby sister, but she was too small to talk, so he began to feel little bored. A fly sat on baby's cheek and he brushed it away. So sometimes a fly, that is the insect makki, a fly sat on baby's cheek and he brushed it away, means he removed it away from his hand. Then he thought what a pretty picture he could make of his sister's lovely face and her little hands. All of a sudden it came in his mind that such a pretty face my sister has. Why don't I draw a picture of her beautiful face, her small little lovely hands. So he kept staring, he kept staring at the little beautiful hands of a baby sister, and suddenly he thought what a pretty picture he could make. He had no paper, but he found a piece of cardboard. He had no pencil, but he found a piece of black charcoal. He began to draw. The baby smiled but did not wake up. Then for drawing he need paper, pencil and other things, but he did not have anything of that sort. So what did he get? He found a piece of cardboard, hardboard means thick paper you can say, and pencil also. There was no pencil, so what did he find? He found a piece of black charcoal, that is a hard black burnt piece of wood. It is a black color, so you can with that you can easily draw on paper. So he started drawing. You can see in the picture a brown color cardboard is there, and he is using black color charcoal. So the baby smiled. Small babies in sleep, they sometimes smile. So the baby was smiling and like it was looking that even she is supporting her brother in making the picture, and she did not get up. She was sleeping. The picture grew as the charcoal touched the cardboard. Here was her round head covered with pretty curls. Here was her mouth. Here were her little round eyes and her small ears. And here were her tiny hands. So means it was completing the picture. As the picture was growing, means as the picture was completing, a very pretty picture was coming out. Her means he was making her curly hair, then her mouth, and then little round eyes and small ears, the tiny hands, everything he was making. Turn the page, children. It was very quiet in the house, and as it was, means nobody was there, even only he was there, it was very quiet and calm in the house. He was so busy drawing that he did not think of anything else. He did not even hear his mother's footsteps as she came into the room. So children, he was so absorbed in the drawing, he was so lost in making drawing that he did not realize that when his mother had come in the room and she saw the picture. "Oh, Benjamin, what have you been doing?" she cried. Her mother was astonished. She was surprised to see the picture that her son was drawing. The boy sprang up, alarmed. Benjamin, he just jumped up suddenly because he was not expecting his mother to come like that. So he was, all of a sudden he jumped up and alarmed. Alarmed means he got scared, frightened, afraid he was. "It's only a picture of the baby, mother," he said. So he did not want to tell his mother that he was actually drawing his sister's photo. He said, "Mama, it is just a picture of a baby, nothing else." His mother was so overjoyed that she hugged him and kissed him. Then suddenly she began to worry. Had Benjamin done the right thing? And that time his mother was so happy, overjoyed. She was so happy, very happy that she hugged her son and she kissed him because that picture was so beautiful. After some time she was worried. Why was she worried? Because as I told you, in older times people were not encouraged to do all these creative things. So she was thinking that is it correct for Benjamin to do these things, because they thought that is useless things, so we should not encourage Benjamin in doing all these things. "Aren't Benjamin, how did you learn to draw such a lovely picture?" she asked. But she asked her son that, "Benjamin, how did you learn? How are you able to draw such a lovely picture?" "I didn't learn it," he answered. "I just did it. I couldn't help but do it." So he said that, "Mother, I have not learned it anywhere. It just came out from my heart. I could not stop myself from making this picture." When Benjamin's father came home, his mother showed him the picture. "It looks like her, doesn't it?" she asked. "But I don't know what to think. Is it very wrong for Benjamin to do such a thing?" she added. So when his father came, his mother showed the picture to Benjamin's father, and it was a mixed kind of feeling in his mother's heart. She was happy also, as well as she was worried also. Happily she showed the picture that this picture looks like Benjamin's baby sister, isn't it? But then she also added that is it correct for Benjamin to do this? Is it not very wrong that he is making pictures and all? So both the feelings she was having. Benjamin's father did not answer. He looked at the picture carefully. Then he handed it back to his wife and said, "Put it away." Now Benjamin's father, although he also liked the picture, but openly he did not express his feelings. Why? Because he did not want to encourage Benjamin to draw more pictures. Because if he would say that, "Oh, it's very nice and very beautiful," then Benjamin would be encouraged and he would draw more pictures. But his father did not want Benjamin to do this because it was, according to them, it was maybe not correct thing. So his father did not say anything and he just asked his wife to put the picture away. Several weeks later, means many weeks later, the priest of their church called on them. Means the priest came to meet to their home. Fathers are there in the church. So one day father came to their home to meet them. The priest was a wise old man with a very pleasant face. So you can see in the picture, children, the next page, father is standing here. So he was very old and wise, intelligent man and with a pleasant face, means happy face, positive face. He was loved and respected by everyone, and just because of this, he was loved and respected by everyone. Everyone followed whatever the priest said. Benjamin's parents decided to show him the picture. They told him how Benjamin was always trying to draw something. They wondered if they should stop him from doing so. So now Benjamin's parents wanted to show the picture to priest, and they showed the picture to a priest, and they also told the priest that Benjamin always wants to draw something, is always interested in drawing, and means they wondered how, if they should, means they knew that they were from the time that people were not encouraged to do creative things, it was not considered good things. So they were surprised that is it right for Benjamin to do this, or should they stop him. The priest looked at the picture for a long time. Then he called Benjamin to him and put his hands on his head. He looked at the picture very carefully, and then he called Benjamin and he put the hand on Benjamin's head to give blessings, because he was so, he admired the picture so much. He liked the picture so much that he wanted to give blessings to Benjamin. This child has a wonderful gift. Why should anyone stop him from doing what he loves? He said, let us hope that Benjamin will grow up to be an honor to our country. Now, to their surprise, what did priest say? He said that your child has a special and wonderful gift, and you should not stop him. In fact, you should encourage him to draw more and more pictures, because this is the special gift that he has got from God, and you cannot stop it. And he was sure that one day Benjamin would grow into a famous artist, or means he can be a honor to our country, he can be a blessing to our country, and he can make the country proud. And the words of the priest came true. Many years later, Benjamin West became a great painter, and his pictures made him very famous. So, children, had the priest not said this, his parents may not encouraged him to develop his talent as an artist, and which made him famous later. So, Benjamin West, 1738 to 1820, this was the time period when he lived, was an American painter. He was very well known for his war paintings, means he used to draw paintings which depicted war. He also taught many artists who became famous painters. Not only he was a famous painter, but he taught many artists also who became later famous painters. So children, this was a story adopted from 50 Famous People by James Baldwin. So I hope you have understood the story, and now I want you all to read the story and learn the word meanings. Thank you.